Hello everyone, and welcome to this third tutorial about TinCAD. In this third tutorial, we're gonna see how we can turn on and off a LED using a push button, which is a simple switch mechanism for controlling some aspect of a machine or a process. So let's see how it will work. So as you can see, this is our circuit. We have, as usual, an Arduino Uno, a breadboard, a LED, and we have also a push button. Okay, so our push button, as you can see here, has four legs. Okay, these two legs are linked together as one leg, and these two legs as well are linked together. Okay, how we connect the push button with the Arduino card? It's so easy. We link it first of all, this leg with the 5 volt pin, and the other leg with a resistor, and then we link it with the ground, as you can see here. Okay, then this same leg, which is linked to the resistor, will be linked with a digital pin, which is, for example, here the pin number 3. Okay, and for the LED, we have seen it already in the previous tutorials. The shortest leg, which is the negative leg, which is the cathode, will be linked with a resistor, which will be linked with the ground. And the other leg, which is the anode, will be linked with a digital pin, which is the pin number 2 in our case. Okay, by the way, you can find the links to our previous tutorials in the description below. Okay, so now this is our circuit. Let's go to the TinkerCAD website and create it. So first of all, I'm gonna create a new circuit. Okay, here we go. Okay, the first thing I'm gonna need is an Arduino Uno board. So I will take it and put it here. And we're gonna need also a breadboard. Okay. So we take it and put it here. Here we go. And we're gonna need a LED. So we take this LED and put it here, for instance, and we're gonna need a push button, which we put it here, and we're gonna need a resistor, which will be linked with the LED, and another resistor, which will be linked with the push button, and I'm gonna rotate it this way. Okay, and grab it right here. Okay, now I will link this leg of the push button with the 5 volt pin. So I will take it and put it here, and I'll change the color to red. Okay, and this is will be linked to the ground, so I will link it to the negative side in this breadboard, and then this will be linked to the ground. Okay, so oops, and here we go. Okay, so this is it. I will change the color to black, and this is to the black. Okay, and this will be linked with the ground, as you can see here, and this will be linked with the pin, sorry, okay, with the pin number 2, as you can see here. Okay, I will change the color to blue, for example, and this will be linked to the pin number 3. Okay, here we go, and I keep it green. Okay, now let's write our code, which will let me do the following. When I push the button, the LED will light up, and when I release it, the LED will turn off. Okay, so let's start writing the code. So we go here to code and change this to text. Okay, and as usual, I'm gonna delete these instructions. Okay, now in the setup function, I will set up our pins mode. So I will write pin mode, and I will write here the pin number 2, which is the pin linked to our LED, and it will be output because it will send a signal to the LED to turn it on or off. Okay, and I will write also pin mode 3, which is linked to our push button, and it will be here input and not in output because we will use it to read the state of the push button. So for that we set up as input. Okay, now let's go to the loop function, and we're gonna start by creating a variable of type int, and we're gonna name it state, for example, in which we're gonna put the state of the push button. And to read the state of the push button, I will use a function called digital read. Okay, and we have used digital and not analog because our pin, which is the pin number 3, which is linked to the push button, is of type digital. So I put here 3, which is the number of our pin. Okay, so this function digital read 3 will give me the value high when I push the button and low when I release the button. For that, I will write the following. So I will write if state, which is the state of our push button, equal to high, and that means that I pushed the button. So in this case, I will light on lights up the LED. So I will write digital. Right, and we have seen how to turn on and off a LED in the previous lectures. So I will write the number of the pin linked to our LED, which is 2, and the value will be high, and that's mean 5 volt. Else, in the other case, which is the state equal to low, and that's mean that I release the push button, in this case I will turn off the LED. So I will write digital right 2 will be low. Okay, and here we go. So to read the state of our push button, we have used digital read, and to turn off or turn on the LED, we have used digital right. Okay, so this is our program. So let's run the simulation now and see the results. So I will close the code and hit the start simulation button. Okay, so as you can see, when I push the button, the LED will turn on, and when I release it, the LED will turn off. I push the button, the LED turns on, I release it, the LED turns off. So this was how we turn on and off a LED using a push button. We will see in next tutorials how we can create more projects using this amazing website. And if you are interested in using Gear components to create this example and many other things, let us know in the comments of this video to create more tutorials about Arduino. I hope that you have enjoyed this tutorial. If so, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel to be informed about our next tutorials.